What is going on, Dank Fam? It's your boy Mike Diesel. Today we're at my dad's shop and we're putting on the new handbrake bracket that we built last night over at my boy Manic Machining's house. And I didn't bring my damn stand with me, so we gotta use jack stands. I don't know if anybody's ever used this trick before, but works like a charm. So we're gonna pull Betty White out of here. Got the brand new Tang's tank on. We got the subframe coming in next week. New cage coming in Monday. This bike's almost done, people. Let's get it! This powder sucks anyways. You and the channel know it. Don't lie to me. Not the frame. We're good, we're good. Always bring your stand, people. This is a lesson to learn. Yeah. It's fine. Oh, we're gravy. It ain't perfect, but it's working. So yeah, in summary, remember to bring a stand. Today is a really exciting day, guys. We spent a couple weeks designing this bracket over at Manic Machining, and it's basically the same brake setup that I use on my bike right now, but all the better amenities that I've always wanted, like not having to get a bigger rear brake line and stuff like that. So one of the easiest things to do as a stunt rider is take your rear wheel off. We got a 6 for the foot brake caliper, and then we got an 8 for my handbrake caliper, which is a monoblock. Then we have a 32 socket for the back axle nut. And then I have a rubber mallet here to knock it all out. Other than that, it's pretty simple. We're just gonna take these calipers off the bracket, take the bracket off, and then slide the new bracket on, mount the calipers up, and see if it's gonna hit the brakes and work at all. I wish we could ride it today, but I'm still waiting on that new cage. But Monday is gonna be the day that we're gonna go ahead and test this bracket out for the first time, and it might get very interesting depending on if the brakes work as they're supposed to or not. But I did find one good use for this cage, which is a great little tripod. So we're gonna take this wheel off real quick and leave a like, leave a comment, and cross your fingers that this new handbrake bracket is gonna work, people, because you know I keep it real with you guys, and if this thing does not work, we're gonna just post it anyways and go back to drawing board. So we're gonna take the calipers off first, and the bike's kind of shifting, so it's getting a little sketchy. You heard that? Yeah, it's a little sketchy out here. And we're gonna use the 8 to get the monoblocks off. And myself personally, just with this bracket, and I'm sure it's gonna be the same with my other bracket, I run 2 washers on each side just to give it a little bit more clearance, because people used to call me Sparky because I would hit my brakes and have a bunch of sparks hitting for whatever reason. But ever since I did the 2 washers, I've lost that nickname. Last but not least, this back axle. Look at that socket, man. Don't leave your stuff in the rain. Oh, we got it on there nice and tight. Oh, damn. I don't know if it's supposed to do that. All right. Rubber mallet, knock the axle through. Moment of truth, people. Slide this puppy out. And the sad part is the Dank Willy engraving's gonna be gone as soon as you slide it in. Well, totally worth it. This is sketchy. Like, I'm trying to put a stump part on. Like, you guys know how it is installing stump parts in general, but just think about you're putting a stump part on that's never been tested to be fitted right. So I could drive myself crazy trying to put this thing on. Actually, I want to test something real quick before we get too crazy here. Okay, I'm just kind of winging it here. So the 2 slots, this is gonna be for like the giveaway bike, 05 all the way up to 2020, and then this is gonna be for 03, 04, or vice versa. So it fits every year's swing arm. Wow. All right, not a shitty part, putting this axle back in. Sometimes you get lucky. Oh no, not today. Oh man, we're lining up, people. Wow. All right, we're gonna take quick 5. I'm about to die, but damn, it looks good.
My dad's filming, so if it's janky video, it's his fault. We got a package from RSE, one of my sponsors. They make all the CNC parts on my bike besides the handbrake bracket just made, but that's the only guy I'm rocking for clutch levers. If anybody's in the stunt community, you know RSE is where it's at. Oh, snap. Oh. That's beautiful. This is his new trigger finger clutch lever, guys. The difference you can see on this one right here. I'm not even just saying it, but I've never had an issue with my fingers slipping off the original. But this one's just gonna lock you in even more. And literally, that trigger finger is no joke. Ho ho ho. Hell yeah. He knows I love green. Got me a green RSC medallion. Awesome stuff. Thank you once again, RSC. We'll get back to trying on this brakes. That's all I gotta do real quick. I'm about to end this video. You can film me in the upper body. So I'm about to finish up this video, guys. All I gotta do is put the calipers on real quick, tap the brakes, and pray that we get some kind of brake pressure. And I would make the bike run and ride it for you guys tonight, but like I said, I have no oil, and we're gonna do everything to the bike on Monday and get it all fixed up. All
right, we need to go to dinner, so I gotta hurry. But these daily uploads are gonna have some family problems. Get off YouTube. You need to spend time with family. But dad, the clout. Aesthetically, I think it's so much more pleasing to have the bigger caliper in the back and then the short one right where it usually is for like a stock bike. And ideally, I just like to make it look clean and should use the power tools. Oh, come on, baby. I was so scared it wouldn't line up. It's coming along though. I have so much confidence in my boy Jake. Don't think I don't, people. This is literally our first attempt at making this bracket. This is me trying it on for the first time, so anything can happen. But with that being said, we got the monoblock threaded up, people. Come on, baby. Give me handbrakey. Yeah. Who's that from? Look at this long brake line. That's because usually you have to run the caliper over here and mount it, but mine, you just mount it right here. Right at the top. Easy peasy, baby. Don't make it complicated. Two bolts right here, real quick, you know what I'm saying? Let's go, baby, good paper. But look at it, people. Oh my gosh. So we got the camera right here. I'm gonna hit the brakes and see if it stops. Ooh, good grab. That's what I'm talking about. Oh yeah, by the way, when I get the new subframe, I'm gonna put this thing on. Shout out to your boy Rob over in Texas. Texas size titanium, baby. All right, we're gonna tighten it down and give it some torque to spec, which is 5 Ugga Duggas. You wanna do the handbrake? Got it, no, the other one. Big, no, the big one. It's working now, jeez. Damn. Yes, good paper, people. So everything looks solid, the brakes are working. So other than that, just this part right here is a little thick and it's kind of near the rotor, so we're gonna trim that up a little bit, but this bracket's pretty much perfect, people.
Alrighty guys, so we successfully installed my first handbrake bracket for the ZX6R. Big shout out to Manic Machine, people. Got so much faith in this guy. He's getting ready to make tons of excellent stunt parts in the future. Next video, we'll have oil on the bike, cage will be fixed, all that good stuff, and we get to riding it for the first time. See how it really does. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to like, comment, subscribe. Like always, keep it dank. Later. I keep mellow every day, I keep mellow every day, I keep mellow, I smoke and keep